Slow clap.
The intro. Nina Simone. Birds flying high.
Yeah. Is that what this is?
All right, thanks so much, Greg. Well, you just said it. It is the biggest game of the year here in the Big East. The rematch of January 20th as Villanova, number 6 in the country, comes here to Omaha to take on number 18, the Creighton Blue Jays. As we take a look at the Big East standings, Villanova has a half-game lead over Creighton. So if Creighton can win here today, that means they will be in control of their own destiny going forward. And hello to everybody, Justin Kutcher alongside Donnie Marshall. And Donnie, as we just said, this is the biggest game of the year in this conference.
For so many reasons. I mean, you have to really start writing things down. If it's a revenge game for Villanova, if it's one of the toughest games and biggest games for Creighton in the history of this program, whatever it might be, it's going to be a big one. You know that.
Yeah, James Bell and this Villanova team will have their work cut out for them. They've been playing very well as of late. James Bell, his season numbers. Well, how about his last 8-game numbers? Even better. He's averaging over 20 a game. He'll be joined in the starting lineup by Hilliard, Archie Diacono, Pinkston, and Ochefu. And for Creighton, well, it always starts with Doug McDermott, the second leading scorer in the country. He shoots over 43% from three-point land. And this starting lineup, they are loaded with three-point shooters. And who can forget about Ethan Rogge, what he did in that first meeting, hitting 7 straight three-pointers to open up the ballgame.
The question is always, how do you guard Doug McDermott? Well, as of late, it's been, how do you Doug Ethan Rogge? You have to put a body on him. How are you going to double off of him? So many questions for Jay Wright. But I think Greg McDermott understands he has something special right here.
Greg McDermott picked up his 100th win as the head coach of the Blue Jays on Thursday. And Jay Wright in his 13th year as the head coach of Villanova. And we're all set for basketball.
Thanks for turning standing as we honor America with the singing of the national anthem. Today's anthem will be performed by Caleb Smith and interpreted by Michaela Creasel.
So proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star spare?
Number 10, Durant!
Welcome to the Ford Fox College Hoops pregame, sponsored by Ford Go Further. We're in Omaha, Nebraska, at the CenturyLink Center, getting set for the rematch. The biggest game of the year here in the Big East, as number 6 Villanova comes to town looking to avenge their loss back on January 20th against number 18 Creighton. This is going to be a good one. The fans are here. They are ready. And why are they ready? Well, look at the standings. Creighton now at 10-2 is a half game behind Villanova. If they can win here today, they will control their own destiny going forward. And hello to everybody, Justin Kutcher alongside Donnie Marshall. And Donnie, it is the biggest game of the year in this conference.
I have to be honest, I have goosebumps. This is what Big East basketball is all about. Whether if it's one team thinking about revenge, another team thinking about validation, this is a huge, huge game for both teams today.
For this Villanova team, they've been playing very well since that loss. It starts with James Bell. He's averaging 16 points in the season, over 21 points per game his last 8. He is joined in the starting lineup with Hilliard, Archidiakono, and up front, it's Pinkston and Ochefu. And of course, for Creighton, if you're going to talk about the Blue Jays, you have to talk about Doug McDermott, the second leading scorer in the country, 2-time first team All-American. He does so much for this team, and the lineup that he is surrounded by, well, they can all shoot. And who can forget what Ethan Rodney did in that first meeting back on January 20th when he had 7 straight three-pointers, 27 in the game. Greg McDermott picked up his 100th victory as the head coach of the Blue Jays in their victory over Butler on Thursday. And on the other side is Jay Wright, 13th season as the head man for the Wildcats. This place is loud. They are ready. Creighton is in gray. Villanova is in blue. The officials, Doug Shouse, Jamie Lucky, and Jim Burr. And we're set for some basketball. And the tip is controlled by Villanova.
You and I were talking before this game. These teams are very similar. They're not the biggest teams around, but they can switch a lot, and they're very quick. They are relentless. One more on offense, the other one on the glass.
Daniel Ochefu backing down against Roggi. The jump hook inside gets it to go.
That's one matchup you're going to have to key on if you're Greg McDermott for Creighton. Roggi, only 6'7", even though he is the center. He's going to need some help down low.
McDermott, the quick three, got it.
How many times have we seen this kid start the game from the top of the key? The spacing is tremendous, and this crowd understands if McDermott gets it going early, it's going to be a big, big night for Creighton.
Archidiakono. Ochefu again against Roggi. Able to muscle through.
Why go away from it? Throw it down inside, force Roggi to be a difference maker.
Oh, back-to-back threes.
You can't continue to leave him open. It's early in the game. You understand that. Communication has to be better. Nip this in the bud while you can if you're Villanova.
Again, looking for Ochefu. The double team comes. Ochefu is short. Pinkston trying to save it. And it will be Creighton basketball.
And really probably the best thing that can happen for Villanova there. Creighton talking to Jay Wright before the game. He tells us, listen, we want to get Creighton in a half court. They're very tough in transition. They have so many options. So not a bad play for Villanova there for that ball to go out of bounds.
Right now, really, it's Doug McDermott 6, Daniel Ochefu 4. McDermott short this time, and a rebound for James Bell. Archidiakono gets inside. Hilliard for 3, that's well short. And out of bounds, it will be Creighton basketball.
I like what Creighton did there defensively. They're going to a zone. They have McDermott up top using some of that length. Archidiakono had a chance to get in the paint. The thing you can't do when you come into this building is try to turn into a Creighton team that spreads you out and shoots the ball for Villanova. Now, with that being said, Villanova has taken more threes than Creighton, but it's on how they get them, driving and kicking.
Grant Gibbs, a 6th year senior, gets to McDermott. McDermott needs some help. Finds a cutting shot. He'll pull it back out. McDermott with the left hand, no good. Ochefu up to Archer Diacono. He gets fouled and he'll head to the free throw line for two. Doug McDermott off to a good start, hit his first 2 3-point attempts, and this place got loud.
Well, just take a look on how much space there is here. Ochefu comes out, you have to come out with a hand up. You can't do it second, and then no one even runs out of there. Again, communication on defense is going to be tremendous for Villanova. I don't care if it's Archie Diacono switching out on the 6'8 McDermott. Someone has to get to him.
Archie Diacono gets the roll, averaging just under 10 points per game, coming off a 14-point performance against DePaul on Wednesday when Villanova won 87-62. The Wildcats have won six in a row since that loss to the Blue Jays on January 20th. Do you think this crowd was ready for this game? The students were lined up 2 hours before they were even allowed to get in. That hands Maniga. Kicks it out to McDermott. Good spin move with the left gutter and a foul.
Most people around the country know Doug McDermott is shooting three-pointers, right? Moves well without the basketball. Well, if he turns himself into a straight-line guy, meaning don't play around with the ball, look at this. Get to the paint, nice little spin move, go right to that rim. He is a tremendous player, just adds another facet to his game.
The fouls against Daniel Ochefu, his first, team's first. McDermott shoots almost 90%, converts a three-point play. He's got all nine here for the Blue Jays. Checking in for the first time is Avery Digman. Digman replaces Jahenz Maniga.
Another really good athlete coming off the bench for Creighton, and Digman, he can switch out as well. He's active, good hands, quickness, can knock down a three-pointer as well if he has time.
We now welcome those of you who are just watching Oregon defeat Oregon State. Justin Kutcher alongside Donnie Marshall here at the CenturyLink Center in Omaha for the biggest game of the season here in the Big East. Number 6 Villanova against number 18 Creighton. And right now, Doug McDermott has all 9 points for the Blue Jays. James Bell. We've got a whistle away from the ball. Three-second violation called against Javon Pinkston.
And again, good defense by Creighton. They're staying in front of guys, not letting them find angles to the basket. And sometimes on that weak side, the big gets stuck in the paint.
Chapman, the pull-up jumper from the free throw line is off, and the rebound for Bell. Ochefu gets run into by Grant Gibbs, and that'll be a foul against Gibbs. That's his first.
If you haven't watched Villanova play a lot this season, you're in for a treat. Don't let the size fool you. They got one guy at 6'11". After that, no one over 6'7".
And that's why these two teams are really similar. Will Artino comes off the bench for Creighton. Artino is 6'11", but besides that, 6'8" McDermott. Chapman back the other way, into the corner. Digman. McDermott on the cut. He's got 11.
The weak side is huge for Villanova defensively. You can't be so sucked over to the sideline that you forget about the middle of the paint.
Listen to this place. Ochefu backing in against Roggi, too strong. Dingman corrals it. Here comes Gibbs. And we've got a foul away from the ball. This will go against Villanova, and it will go against Javon Pinkston. The score right now, 11-6, all 11 points from that guy. Doug McDermott, a couple of threes, the old-fashioned three-point play, and a drive to the hoop, 11-6, Creighton on top.
edition of Love It Winners are voting seats, we'd like to direct your attention to the video board where Elena, our verified fan of the game, is standing by. Congratulations, Elena. You won a $100 gift card to the Ameriprime online store and a $10 gift card to Billy Blue's Alumni Grill located on Creighton's campus. Fans, please give a round of applause for Elena.
Seen high hopes. These two teams have high hopes and they're playing very well. But Doug McDermott, look at the start that he's off to. He scored all 11 points so far for the Creighton Blue Jays. And with those 11 points, he has now passed Otis Birdsong. He is now a number 14 all-time in NCAA scoring. The guy he trails is Larry Bird for number 13. Larry Bird at 28-50. McDermott right now 28-35.
Well, it's fitting that we play Bruce Springsteen coming out because that kid right there is the boss. Anywhere you go in this town, they know who he is. Talk about the amount of pressure. Every game you have, if you're Creighton, you know the fanfare is there. You know the pressure. How are you going to stop this guy? Well, he handles it so very well.
McDermott, they switch on him. Chapman gets inside, can't finish. Bell with a rebound. In for the first time is Tony Chenault. Archie Diacono finding Javon Pinkston. James Bell, top of the key three. And that is a key for Greg McDermott and this team. They want James Bell to put the ball on the floor. Don't let him catch and shoot.
And when you talk about James Bell, you have to talk about him with the other good seniors. Bryce Cotton, Doug McDermott. He's probably one of the least heralded of the seniors in this conference.
I agree with you. Gibbs, strong take to the hoop, got it, and the foul.
This game is about, for Creighton, Doug McDermott and the X Factors. Grant Gibbs is one of those X Factors, the sixth year senior. Good recognition, ripping it through the baseline. Defense shows up too late. And take a look, no one there. You got to get there sooner than that. But again, a heads up play from a veteran player.
The foul is called against Tony Chenault, his first, the team's third. Grant Gibbs the free throw line, converts the three-point play. Five-point lead for the Blue Jays. 14 and a half to play here in this first half. Bell, he gets called for steps. Substitution now, Devin Brooks will check in for the first time. Just kidding. Brooks was gonna check in, said it's Will Artino who's in. And now Brooks goes back to the scorer's table. McDermott, double pump, puts it in off the glass.
Ball pressure has to be much better though. When you're guarding the wing, you have to deflect. Somehow, hand in front of his face, hands in the air, shadow the ball. You can't let a clean catch happen.
Chenault to the hoop, gets fouled by Artino and gets it to go.
Take a look, moves so well without the ball. McDermott, but look at the ball pressure. Got to do a better job. Get up into that player a little bit better. Your Archie Diacono, and then here, man, again, the cut. It just, he moves so well. He understands, but not only that, when we talk about players recognizing where the spots are, how to cut to them hard, but it's even more important for your teammates to know where you're cutting and to know where to put that ball.
5-point lead for Creighton. Martino is open underneath. Brooks got a screen, pulls up, 13 can't hit it, and a rebound for Darren Hillier. Chenault pulls up, the free throw line jumper is no good, and a rebound, Avery Dingman. Anagaw back in. McDermott thought about the three in transition. Loose it out of bounds. It's off to him. And it will be Villanova basketball.
That's the one place that Villanova, especially Pinkston, can really disrupt what McDermott is trying to do. Make him put the ball on the floor. Another guy. Same way they want to play Bell. Villanova has to play McDermott that way. Make him dribble the basketball.
McDermott goes to the bench for a breather with 13 points. Roggie's back in. Josh Hart, the freshman for Villanova's in the game for the first time. Archie Diacono, the deep three. Trying to save it as Bell. Loose ball, it's Roggie. Here comes Maniga. Dingman finds Artino underneath. And Artino puts it in.
Artino's got to know, though, he got away with one. You can't put the ball on the floor. You got a 6'2 guy running at you. You're a foot away from the basket. Go straight up. You might have been able to get a foul.
Hilliard for three to quiet the crowd.
They're tough. Villanova understands. Extension of their coach. Play with toughness. Don't let the crowd get you out of it. Big shot.
McDermott goes back to the scorer's table. A moving screen will be called here against Ethan Roggie. That is the first against Roggie, the team's fourth. Substitutions back in the game as McDermott checking in for the first time, Isaiah Zierden. Archie Diacono, the pull-up jumper, no good. Rebound by Zierden.
I like the aggressiveness, though. Use that screen, come off, shot a good shot.
McDermott sets the screen for Brooks, all the way to the hoop, got it, and the foul. Bell picks up the foul. McDermott set the pick, and Devin Brooks took advantage. Takes the contact, finishes. He'll go to the free throw line, trying to convert the three-point play when we come back. Welcome back to Fox College Hoops, presentation of Big East Basketball, brought to you by New York Life Insurance Company, here in Omaha at the CenturyLink Center. Sold out crowd, 17,390. Creighton leading Villanova by 6, 20-14. And today's New York Life Keep Good Going stat. Well, look at these two teams and look at what they have done offensively in the Big East. They're the top two in, I guess you could say, five of the six areas. The one area is field goal percentage. Villanova's third. At the free throw line will be Devin Brooks trying to convert the three-point play. Doug McDermott has got 13 points here in the early going. Devin Brooks, a junior college transfer, averaging almost 8 points per game. You know what's scary? You look at the numbers offensively for this Blue Jays team. He shoots 33% from three-point land. And that's bad for this team.
I mean, you have to understand, he doesn't get a ton of minutes either, so you got to give him some credit. They're starting to trust in him a little bit more, but I understand what you mean.
Archie Diacono for three.
A lot of time. He is tough. You talk about sophomores in this conference. He's one of the tougher ones. You would never know what year he was if you watched him play three or four games in a row.
He's got 5 points. Brooks goes right at him, puts it off the glass. No good. The rebound for Josh Hart. Bell back the other way. Bell can't finish, but the tip in by Hart.
Athletes, they say they're small, but they can get out in transition.
Zierman gets the screen, turns the corner. Fadeaway puts it in.
The auxiliary guys, so important in this game for Creighton especially. Guys you don't expect to step up and make moves, but that floor's gonna be spaced out. The middle's gonna be wide open because Nova's staying home on the shooters.
Isaiah Zierman, his father, is an assistant with the Washington Wizards in attendance here today because of the All-Star break. And that's out of bounds off of Rogge. Substitutions, Grant Gibbs will check back in, as does Austin Chapman. And for the first time, Dylan Ennis comes in for Villanova. James Bell goes to the bench. Ochefu, who had the first 4 points of the game for Villanova, now a reach-in foul called against Grant Gibbs.
And just not a smart play. Well, their last game, they played against Butler. Same thing for Gibbs, just too many fouls early, and now he has to go to the bench. That's a huge, huge loss early in this game, especially with the emotion. He's one of their emotional leaders, and you don't need that foul there. You know, just play safe, stay in front of your guy, no reaching. I always say, show the refs your hand so they know you're not reaching in.
He goes to the bench, Sheeran comes back in, and Hilliard gets his man up in the air. That'll be a foul against Maniga, and Hilliard will go to the free throw line for three. So how about the job that Villanova has done? Because Creighton got off this fantastic start, the crowd was going crazy. Well, now three free throws for Hilliard. He could make this a one-point game.
Yeah, we talked to him about getting out of Chicago, that game against DePaul, Villanova. Talk about weathering the storm. They were trying to get back before the storm in the Northeast. They have done that today, weathered the storm of Creighton, the crowd. I mean, you can hear a pin drop now. We started this game, we could barely hear ourselves talk. Suddenly, the Wildcats look up, and now it's a two-point game.
Avery Dingman comes in, replacing Maniga. And Pinkston's back in for Josh Hart for Villanova. Talk about underrated players in the Big East. I think this guy, Hilliard, is one of the most underrated in the conference.
I couldn't agree with you more.
The miss and a good rebound and save by Rogge. Aggressive defense here by Villanova. Chapman, kick out. Dingman to the hoop. He can't finish, and a rebound for Ennis. Ennis lost it, and it's out of bounds off of Villanova. James Bell will come back in to replace Darren Hilliard.
Have to give Creighton credit there, getting back, retreating. That's what Villanova wants to do. They want to run it right down your throat.
It's one of the keys for Greg McDermott here tonight for Creighton is to get back transition defense. Doug McDermott pulls up for three. Got it!
You have to guard him with your hand up. That's tough for Ochepu. He's used to playing guys down in the post. He almost has to take the same principle as if he was down low guarding McDermott on the perimeter. Keep that hand up. Rely on your help if he beats you off the dribble.
They're having Doug McDermott bobblehead night next Sunday. Maybe it should have been this Sunday.
I should say as we sit here, it's easy for me to say. I got a suit and tie on. And McDermott is a tough guard. I mean, you can't take away how special he is. But look at the hands down. That's just too late. He recognizes. You talk so much about his ability to shoot the ball, move without the ball, but he recognizes, too, when he needs to make a basketball play, the hands are down, you got to shoot it.
And look at this. Jay Wright makes the change. He takes Ochepu out. He goes small to match up against the Blue Jays. McDermott moving all over the place. Chapman. Shot clock is down to 10. Shot clock now at 6. Chapman for 3. In and out. And a rebound for Bell. They've got numbers and they push it. Ennis spots up for 3. Got it. Dylan Ennis, the transfer from Rice. He could be a spark off the bench. Zierden answers with a 3.
Toughness. Belief. That's what we're getting from both teams. The X Factors are stepping up. Zierden now with 5 points.
What a great first half of basketball here in Omaha. Ennis, step back jumper. Can't get the roll, the rebound for Dingman. The defense that time by Jenkins, not giving McDermott any room to move. McDermott, fadeaway, got it. He's got 18.
Terrific defense. What else can you ask for? Uses the body, fades away off the 1 foot. Dirk Nowitzki-esque.
And now a foul away from the ball. And this will go against Isaiah Zierden. 7-point lead for Creighton. First, it's Isaiah Zierden. You said it, the X Factors. Who are going to be those guys who step up? Zierden has an answer three. And then McDermott going Dirk Nowitzki. The step back, 7-point lead for the Blue Jays.
Thank you.
So this is the world premiere of the Doug McDermott bobblehead. They will be giving out next Sunday. A limited number. You have to get here early. Maybe they should have this today because Doug McDermott is 7-for-9 with 18 points here in the first half.
Well, so far, the Villanova heads have been bobbleheads, chasing him around, looking all over the place for him. I mean, there has been a lot of criticism, people saying who all the player of the year should be. Julius Randle, Jabari Parker, Wiggins, take your pick, Ennis. Well, there's a senior that's pretty good right there in your screen, folks. I believe we'll be the player of the year, and he's letting everyone know today that he should be as well.
It's amazing because he entered this game 26 points shy of Larry Bird for 13th place on the all-time NCAA scoring list. He may hit 26 in his first half. We've got 7:37 to go. He's at 18 right now. At the free throw line for Villanova is Dylan Ennis. Ennis, the redshirt sophomore of Brampton, Ontario. It's the free throw. Creighton does have 17 fouls. So Villanova in the bonus.
Important for Villanova as well. Getting to the line. Slowing this game down just a little bit. You got to take a guy like McDermott out of rhythm any way you can. Putting that head down, getting to the basket, trying to force the officials to make a call will help you the last 7:37 in this half.
Ennis goes to the bench with 5 points. Back in the game is Hilliard. 5-point lead for the Blue Jays. McDermott looks for the screen. Chapman pulls up, no good. Artino keeps it alive, and the rebound by Javon Pinkston. The crowd trying to implore the defense here for the Blue Jays. Hilliard, good hesitation, with the right hand puts it in.
That's your guy, does so many things well. You said it, the unsung hero in maybe all of college basketball.
31-28, Villanova weathering this Doug McDermott storm of 18 points here in the first half. Coming up on 6.5 to play. Chapman goes baseline. Good ball movement. Zierden had the three, pass it up, now pulls up for two.
IZ is feeling it, folks. Good move there, too. We get the defense to freeze. One dribble, they're on their heels. Nice little pull up with the extension.
33-28, number 18, Creighton, leading number 6, Villanova. In the corner, Jenkins for three. And the rebound by Artino. Brooks going at Bell with the left hand.
You can't fall asleep because the player you're guarding is not named Doug McDermott. You have to guard everyone on the floor for Villanova.
30-second timeout taken by Jay Wright. A 7-point lead matches the largest of the game for the Blue Jays with 5:52 to go here in the first half. Creighton leads Villanova here with 5:52 to go in the first half. Justin Kutch alongside Donnie Marshall in front of a raucous crowd here at CenturyLink Center. McDermott's got 18 points, but you talk about the guys stepping up. In the first meeting, everyone knows it was Ethan Rogge. He had 24 points in the first half. Ethan Rogge doesn't have a point here so far tonight, but it's guys like Isaiah Zierden. It's Austin Chapman, Devin Brooks stepping up for this Creighton team. Has a size advantage here. Jenkins, the freshman, missed the turnaround, kept alive by Achefu. James Bell for three. Got it. Second three of the half for James Bell.
You got the scouting report, but obviously Creighton did. You got to make him put it on the floor. You mentioned that earlier. You don't want him catching and shooting if you're Creighton.
Zierden puts it on the floor again. Gets it swatted by O'Sheffield. McDermott has it, 15 on the shot clock. Martino Rowland couldn't handle a pass and a turnover by Creighton.
All set up by the deflection, though. I really believe deflections are a huge part of this game, and I believe they should become an official stat, because if that's not deflected, that's an easy layup or a dunk for Martino there. Player gets a deflection on that, and a lot of teams, you know, Buzz Williams at Marquette, he charts deflections, which, again, it's a huge part of disrupting and changing the course of games.
McDermott goes to the bench. Rogge is back in. Also Avery Dingman with Artino, Chapman, and Zierden for Creighton. For Villanova, it's Archie Diacono, Hilliard, O'Sheffield, Bell, and Josh Hart. Under five to play here in the first half. Offensive foul against James Bell. And that is number two against Bell.
At first sight, and I'm going to say this before the replay, I don't agree with it. I just don't agree with it. I think this is a physical game. He's at 13 feet from the basket. If it was underneath and the little guy's guarding him, I just think there was a trip there. I really do not agree that should have been an offensive foul.
The officials going to the replay monitor. They're going to want to see where the elbow came up here for Bell.
See, I just don't agree with that. I think that was a natural movement. I think that if you watch Chapman's right arm, he pulls Bell's left arm towards him. I don't think there was anything derogatory about that. I think Chapman sold it.
And again,
to be honest,
the initial elbow towards the face, it didn't seem like there was any intent. It's the fact that James Bell is about 6'6", and Chapman's listed at 6 feet, and they're going to say no flagrant, which I agree with.
And just because a player throws his head back, the officials understand, let's find the contact first. Let's not just overreact about how the player fell. The crowd doesn't like it, but it's the right call. Absolute right call. Well, first of all, let me go back. The right call is to not call a technical with the elbow to the face, but I do not agree with the call that it was an offensive foul.
Right, and that is a big offensive foul, number two against Bell, so he has to go to the bench. He's got two for Villanova. Gibbs has two for Creighton. Chapman in some trouble, and he's going to call a timeout with 19 on the shot clock.
Great defense by Archie Diacono. Anytime a player's leaning away, you just go in with your body, force him out even more.
Tuesday, Big East basketball presented by New York Life Insurance Company returns with a doubleheader as the 6th-ranked Villanova Wildcats take on Providence, followed by Butler battling St. John's. Coverage begins at 7 Eastern. That's all part of Speed Weeks right here on Fox Sports 1. You know, you got the game here tonight. You've got these games coming up on Tuesday. At this point, as we take a look at the Big East standings and look at all these teams bottled up between Xavier and St. John's, every game each night has big implications.
And it depends, too, where you're playing. You know, if you're a team that struggles on the road, you have to buckle down and really start to tighten things up. You know, coaches always say, we got to tighten it up without tightening up, and that's the hardest thing to tell kids and to teach them this time of year.
19 on the shot clock. Dingman to inbound here for Creighton. Chapman left open for three.
Chapman,
he only shoots 42% from three-point land.
Villanova 7th in the Big East in three-point field goal defense. So that may be one of the spots where they struggle, but it can't happen today.
Hilliard shot is short. Rebound chased down by Dingman. Chapman on Chapman. This is not a good matchup. Dingman really lost the dribble. Maybe traveled. Instead, it's Sartino underneath, goes the reverse.
Tough matchup for the young Kellar. Archie Diacono down low.
Largest lead of the game here for the Blue Jays. Archie Diacono, kick out. Hilliard, good bump fake. Archie Diacono, the corner three. No good. Rebound to Dingman. Little crazy play. No one wants to touch. We get a backcourt violation. 3 minutes to go here in the first half. 9-point lead for Creighton. They've got the mismatch underneath. The lob pass. Sartino got hit. No basket. A foul on the floor. They are not in the bonus. They'll be taking it out underneath when we come back. Austin Chapman's parents are in attendance, wearing his jersey, and they're cheering because their son hits the three and gives his team that 9-point lead. How are you, man?
Greg.
Thanks so much, Greg. We are back here, sold out CenturyLink Center. And they're watching. There's Creighton Blue Jays lead by 9 over number 6 Villanova. Now get this. This is the first time a ranked Creighton team is hosting another ranked team since it was number 5 Marquette against number 13 Creighton back on March 8th of 1975.
And you weren't even a thought.
Not even close.
That's a long time ago. If you think about it and you understand what you have here today, that's what makes this game so much bigger.
McDermott's back in. Going right to the hoop, misses, gets the rebound, puts it back in, he's got 20.
That's one thing if you give him a shot, but it's an entirely different issue and a big issue if you let him go get his own shot and hurt you.
Archie Diacono keeps the dribble alive. Ennis for three. In and out, the rebound. Pinkston puts it back, no good. And McDermott's got the rebound. Roggie asking for it. McDermott against Hilliard. Mc- McDermott got hit on the shot. He'll go to the free throw line.
Talk about the way McDermott moves without the basketball. One of the best in the country. Take a look. He's going to pop. When he curls, right there, all this space is wide open. He recognizes it, but this can't happen. You can't give him an offensive rebound. Again, I think the communication is lacking just a little bit on Villanova's side defensively. Too many open spaces for a lot of guys.
McDermott with his 21st 20-point game this year. He's got 22 here in the first half, and his team leads 44-31, a 9-0 run for the Blue Jays. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. James Bell is back in with those two fouls. Hilliard, offensive foul.
Now, I agree with that call. That's a good call. Anytime you extend that left arm, that's an easy call for the official. The turnover starting to really become a problem for Villanova. Look at that. Good defense. Square the guy up. And then once you extend, pretty much tells the ref, go ahead, blow that whistle.
The third foul against Darren Hilliard. He has to go to the bench. And did you see the emotion there by Artino looking at his teammate Avery Dingman when he picked up the foul? This team is playing with a lot of emotion here today. Ochefu will be called for the foul, and Rogge will head to the free throw line.
Villanova foul on number 23, Daniel Ochefu, his second personal, that's the 19th foul.
Number two against Ochefu. Rogge at the free throw line, an 82.6% free throw shooter. And Ochefu's going to have to go to the bench. Chris Jenkins checks in. So think about the foul trouble right now for Villanova. You've got Ochefu with two, Bell with two, Hilliard with three. And oh yeah, you're trailing 44-31.
Oh, and I have another oh yeah for you. That's Rogge's first point of this game.
Everyone would agree that first meeting, which was all Creighton in Philadelphia, that Creighton is not a 30-point margin better than Villanova. But right now, they lead by 15.
Yeah, this is a big game for both teams, recognizing who they really are.
James Bell for three. Big shot for the senior.
Hands down again. Good players recognize it.
James Bell has nine, and that quiets this crowd for now. Chapman, the kick out. Dingman for three.
How about the bench? How about guys coming in for Creighton, doing the job? You can count on them. Greg McDermott has to be so happy with the way his guys are responding off the bench.
Bell for three again, got it. That's his fourth three of the half. And right now, he is stepping up for his team when they need him the most. Bobble, loose ball on the floor, whose ball? It's going to be Creighton basketball.
And we talked about Bell being one of those unsung guys as well. Look at this, one dribble, Dingman again. You're running under him, you got to put a hand up. This is twice now, no hand up. Your back is basically turned to him. That was a terrific, terrific move. But defensively, you got to put a hand in the face.
Zierden back in here for Creighton. The Blue Jays up by 12. Dingman aggressive to the hoop, and a blocking foul will be called against Ennis. Two shots here for Avery Dingman. Again, if you're just joining us late, this first half has belonged to Doug McDermott. McDermott here in the first half has 22 points on 8 of 11 from the floor. Dingman hits the free throw. Ethan Rogge, who had that great first half the first time these teams met, has just 2 points so far, and both those points came at the free throw line. But it's been other guys stepping up.
Yeah, 50 points. The rest of the starters have eight. The bench now for Creighton has 20 points. Really stepping up. We talked about that off the top. The auxiliary players is what I like to call them. Guys that you don't expect to have big games, they're really stepping up for Creighton.
A violation against the shooter, Avery Dingman. He knew the shot was short right away, and he was the first one to go after it.
And that's okay, because now the ball stops. You have a chance if you're Creighton to set up your defense and try to get a half-court stop.
Do you hold for the final shot here if you're Villanova?
No question. You need some momentum going in at halftime. Down 13.
Greg McDermott telling his team, hey, back up, back up. They're not going to go till probably under seven. Ennis gets the screen. Ennis the kick out. Archie Diacono finds Ennis, who can't hit from up close.
He's scoring at the half, the Blue Jays.
A 15-6 run for the Blue Jays to close out the half. Creighton 50, Villanova 37. 25 consecutive wins for the Blue Jays when leading at the half. You're watching Big East Basketball on Fox Sports 1, your exclusive home for the entire Big East Tournament. Doug McDermott, 22 points in the first half to lead his team to a 13-point margin. After the break, we'll get you back to Greg and Austin in our Fox College Hoop Studios for halftime.
Thank you.
Thank you.
James Bell.
Right now, it's all Creighton once again, 50-37. They lead Villanova here as we get set to start the second half. Justin Kutcher alongside Donnie Marshall. And Donnie, it's pretty remarkable what this Creighton team has done in the first half. 22 points for Doug McDermott.
Yeah, and for the bench, 20 points, 22 points in the paint. I mean, they're really dominating Villanova all over the place. And remember, a couple guys haven't really helped. Grant Gibbs, Ethan Rogge, they really have been non-existent in this game, really due to good defense and then foul trouble.
It was McDermott who got this team off to a great start, scored the first 11 points for this team. 22 points on 8 of 11 from the floor.
Well, his teammates are finding it right. He trails there, knocks it down. But you and I talked about this again, 20 bench points, you can't stress it enough. The auxiliary player stepping in, there you see Isaiah Zierden. And then here, James Bell has kept his team in this game, 4-5. From the field, 12 points, but you're going to have to do more of that and get more from his teammates in the second half.
You look at the first half stats, and look at the shooting percentage. 62% for Creighton. In that first meeting, they shot 59.4%. They're shooting better tonight than they did that first game when they torched Villanova. And the points in the paint advantage for Creighton, pretty remarkable. I mean, this Villanova team, they kind of weathered a storm. And all of a sudden, the Blue Jays, they went on a 15-6 run to close out the half.
Yeah, points in the paint means something much different than it did 10, 15 years ago when I played. Points in the paint meant you were posting up. Guys were throwing the ball down low. You were making good post moves. Now, today, they're transition. They're cutting. That's exactly what McDermott was doing in the first half. That's how the points in the paint is so high for Creighton.
Gibbs back on the floor and had those two quick fouls in the first half. Maniga didn't see much time in the first half. McDermott against Ochefu. McDermott gets his man up in the air. Shot clock down to 7. Chapman a deep 3. Well off an air ball. And that'll be out of bounds. Villanova basketball.
Good D there by Villanova. Ochefu staying on the ground. McDermott not wanting to force the shot over him. I think Villanova has to dirty this game up a little bit. I think they got to get more physical. They have to do more going to the front of that rim with the ball.
Javon Kingston, a quiet first half. Hilliard with 3 fouls with a right can't finish, trying to keep it alive. It's out of bounds off of him.
But they did exactly what they wanted to do. Carve, get to the basket. You just have to be able to finish around. No shot blockers on the floor. Really, Ochefu's out there by himself. But Creighton, you have to understand, you're Villanova. They have no shot blockers.
Javon Kingston, no points in that first half, just 2 rebounds. Maniga, the kick out. And the turnover. James Bell has it. So 2 poor offensive possessions for Creighton to start the second half. Kingston gets doubled right away. Ochefu underneath will lay it in.
And that's exactly the game plan. Double Kingston. He's going to have to become a better passer out of that double team.
Gibbs throws up a wild shot and gets it to go.
You can see what he gives you, right? I mean, it's not pretty, but it's effective. And when he's sitting on the bench, obviously he can't do those things for you.
In the 3 games since his return from a dislocated knee, Gibbs, the 6th-year senior, has averaged 8, 6, and 6. McDermott against Kingston. Maniga underneath, looking for the foul against Bell, no whistle. James Bell gets tripped up by Maniga, and that's going to be number 3 against Jahans Maniga.
Well, Grant Gibbs sitting on the bench in that first half because of foul trouble. But here, attack, get to the body and throw it up. That's like a 60-foot putt in golf, hit and hope. That was a throw it up and hope something good happens.
Folks, Donnie Marshall's a 1 handicap. He doesn't hit and hope too often.
Don't say that too loud.
Back in the game is Avery Dingman for Maniga. Bell to 3, no good. His first miss from 3, and we're going to have a foul here against Javon Kingston, shoving his man out of the way, trying to get the rebound.
It's the Wildcats' first team foul of the second half. The
timing of those is tough. When you're going to box out and the guy's jumping, and then the guy kind of flails a little bit, it's just, you know, the box out has to come earlier or none at all.
Blue Jays just 2 points so far in this half. McDermott against Kingston. He gets doubled by Bell in the corner. Good double team that time, and a timeout is taken here by the Blue Jays. 52-39, 17-18 to go here in the second half. Creighton leading number 6, Villanova.
round of applause for our winner and all of our participants today. And a big thank you to Pepper Against Grill for their sponsorship of Creighton Athletics. Visit Pepper Against Grill's 8 Omaha area locations. Pepper Against Grill catering, trick for office meetings, parties, and more. Pepper Against Grill, America's best Philly.
Next Sunday, the Daytona 500 returns to Fox as the world's best drivers compete in the Great American Race. Speed Weeks continues on Fox Sports 1 all week long, leading up to the Daytona 500 next Sunday at noon Eastern, only on Fox. We've got a race on our hands here tonight in Omaha, 52-39. The Creighton Blue Jays ranked number 18th in the country against number 6 Villanova. Out of the timeout, let's see what the Blue Jays do. If you had a baseball pass for the inbounds, you just won. Gibbs, shot clock at 10. Roggy for 3. No good. And the rebound by Pinkston, and that should have been a travel. Hilliard the kick out. Archie Diacono on the floor. Bodies are all over it. Jump ball possession error will be Villanova basketball.
Great play by Dingman, though. I mean, take a look at how far away he is when he dives for this ball. I mean, this is hustle. Check that out. I mean, he is full extension. That's hungry right there. Four guys on the floor.
Josh Hart checking in for the Wildcats.
Tough pass there off the back of Chapman's leg, but Dingman doing a terrific job. Great hustle.
Hilliard to inbounds, 23 on the shot clock. Trying to get it to Ochefu against Roggy. In the corner, Hart, shot clock at 8. Shot clock at 5. Archie Diacono goes into McDermott. Does not get a call. A shot clock violation.
Hart has to know that ball's in the corner. You cannot kick it to half court with 6 seconds to go. You have to start to work into your move. You've got to have more confidence.
By the way, really cool moment right there. Doug McDermott walking by his dad, Greg McDermott, after the violation. They high-five. That's a reason why he comes back for his senior year. Plays one more year with his dad as his head coach. A foul away from the ball. This will go against Ochefu. And that's number 3 against Daniel Ochefu. A couple of substitutions. First Jenkins and James Bell come back in, replacing Hart and Ochefu.
Fouls adding up right now for Villanova. 3 Ochefu, 3 for Hilliard, 2 for Bell, 2 for Pinkston. I mean, they are really, really starting to add up.
Slow start to second half for both teams, just 2 points apiece. We're almost 4 minutes in. Chapman the kick out. Gibbs for 3. Got it.
Gibbs for 3.
Largest lead of the day. 16 points. Jenkins for 3. Short. Bell trying to keep it alive. Up ahead for McDermott. Timeout, Villanova. off the turnover. McDermott with his easiest two of the day. He's got 24. And it's an 18-point lead. Are still going crazy here at the CenturyLink Center in Omaha, 57-39. The rematch of that January 20th game when Creighton went on the road to the Wells Fargo Center in Philadelphia and just crushed Villanova. Villanova's got to go on a run here soon. Out of bounds, and it will stay Villanova basketball. 15:08 to play here in the second half. Greg McDermott's crew is looking good as they lead by 18 at home. Today's AT&T Impossible Feat, the 1979 championship game, was the beginning of one of the greatest rivalries in the history of basketball. Magic Johnson's Michigan State Spartans against Larry Bird, the Indiana State Sycamores. Magic and the Spartans, they won. Those two players would meet up three times in the NBA Finals. Magic won two of those three with the Lakers. And speaking of Larry Bird, look who's creeping up on him. Doug McDermott just 2 points shy of tying him, 3 points shy of moving in to number 13 all time for Division I basketball. And by the way, Larry Bird, one of the guys that McDermott grew up and still to this day watches on YouTube. Javon Pinkston into the body of Rogge, he draws the foul. And he'll go to the free throw line.
That's what Villanova has to do. They'll continue to go with the guys. No one really for Creighton has been challenged as far as one-on-one defense. You know, not that you should come out here and try to just play hero ball. Because right now, Villanova has 7 assists and 8 turnovers. That's dormy. That's a golf term. You never want to have more assists or less assists than you have turnovers. And not only that, you know, you only have 13 field goals. So you're giving the ball back to a team that can score. We know that. But you have to continue to force them to defend you if you're Villanova.
And those 2 points were the first 2 points for Javon Pinkston, who averages almost 15 per game. A foul away from the ball. Who will this be on? Is it on Jenkins or Archie Diacono? It's going to be on Archie Diacono.
And he has to be smarter than that. Grant Gibbs is really a terrific player when it comes to setting guys up. You know, he's going to bait you. And the younger Diacono has to know, keep your hands in.
That's what 6 years of experience does for you. Gibbs all the way to the hoop. No one's there. Kingston against Rogge again. Got it in the foul. His first field goal of the day.
And you have to understand how important this kid is. Take a look. Here he is. He's going to carve all the way down. This weak side help has to step up, step in, and take a charge. You can allow Dingman on that left side to stand out there and recover to him. I think it's important to point out about Grant Gibbs. Now, he's on a scholarship only because Doug McDermott gave up his scholarship to get Gibbs a chance to play basketball this season. So, to me, Doug McDermott is the best walk-on in the history of the game of basketball.
Dingman to the hoop. He's able to put it in. We could have the National Player of the Year be a walk-on.
Absolutely. Technically, he's a walk-on, Doug McDermott.
Timeout, Villanova.
Timeout, Villanova. 61-44. Creighton leading Villanova with 14:09 to go. Tomorrow, get in the ring with Monday Night Fights for a full card of action, including a bout between Enrique Caboto and undefeated Manuel Tino Avila. It all starts at 10 p.m. Eastern, and it's all part of Speed Weeks right here on Fox Sports 1. Johnny Marshall, let me ask you this question. We speak to Jay right before the game. Both these teams are so good. What is it about the Creighton Blue Jays that Villanova doesn't match up well with? Because on paper, you would think it would be a great matchup for both teams.
Well, it's one guy, Doug McDermott. You saw the game starting with Ochefu guarding him. Couldn't do it. He's not accustomed to playing guys that far away from the basket, especially guarding one of the best, if not the best, college basketball player today. Then you put a smaller guy on him, he's going to cut. He has the advantage at 6'8". I mean, it's a great situation to be in. A lot of great players in the NBA do the same thing. Kevin Durant, you put a guard on him, he shoots over the top. You put a big on him, he goes by. Now, Doug McDermott's game is not set up yet. It's not that advanced to go by guys, but he's smart enough to know if there's a bigger guy on him, move your feet, good things happen.
Out of the timeout, here's Villanova. Pinkston pulls up short. Pinkston gets the rebound. Ennis for three. Gets the roll.
Soft rims here at CenturyLink. They needed that to go down. That's from all the three-pointers Rogge and McDermott shoot on him.
Now an offensive foul against Doug McDermott. Turnover for Creighton. Dylan Ennis has 7 points off the bench for Villanova.
Listen, this game by no means is over. You have a ton of time if you're Villanova. You make a couple buckets, get a couple stops. Now you get Creighton thinking a little bit.
But a walk, James Bell, offensive foul, an illegal screen against Ochefu, and that's going to be number 4.
You have to tighten things up, stand still, especially on a moving guard. When he comes off of this, you cannot lean in. Exactly what happens there. Villanova really hampered by giving the ball back to Creighton all night long.
Ochefu goes to the bench with those 4 fouls. Josh Hart, the freshman, comes back in. So 13:36 to go. Ochepu picks up his fourth foul. That's the second straight game he's been plagued by foul trouble. Was in foul trouble and fouled out against DePaul on Wednesday. McDermott for three. Got it!
McDermott for three!
And how fitting, with a three, he moves past Larry Bird.
Pretty special, huh? Boy.
He needed 26 to tie him. He's got 27 in a reach and foul against Artino.
We had a terrific, terrific angle at this right behind, lined up when he comes off of this bottom of your screen there. Look how deep he is. That's behind NBA range. That's a tough guard for anyone, but his teammates set it up.
Bell attacking the hoop, and a blocking foul will be called. That'll be against Artino. That's number three against Will Artino, but you like to see the aggressiveness by James Bell.
Yeah, coming off recognition, you can go, and we just talked about that. Check the foot speed, test the foot speed of the perimeter guys for Creighton. It hasn't really been done today because you're always retreating back in half court because Creighton's not missing it.
Bell at the free throw line. Now has 13 points. Hilliard and Jenkins come back in for Villanova. Checking in for the first time for Creighton will be Jack Hansen. And also Devin Brooks back in, replacing Austin Chapman. Artino went the bench with those three fouls. Bell on the season, shoots 80% from the free throw line. Makes both. 15-point lead for the Blue Jays. Off the made free throw, setting up the press is Villanova. Shot clock at 10. McDermott against the freshman Jenkins. Good footwork with the left goes in.
Just not fair. You put a freshman in the mixer. Dr. McDermott, you should feel bad for that move right there.
29 for McDermott. Hart, nice take. Under the basket, nowhere to go. Gives to McDermott for three. Hanson the offensive rebound, and he gets fouled. Everybody in this crowd wanted that three to go down for McDermott. The Blue Jays 66, the Wildcats 49 here in Omaha.
Thank you.
Welcome back to Fox College Hoops, presentation of Big East Basketball, brought to you by New York Life Insurance Company. It is now nighttime here in Omaha, but the lights have been on. Number three for Creighton, Doug McDermott, all game long, 29 points. He has been as advertised, if not even better.
A lot of factors when you talk about great players, but just check out the feed here. Shot clock is under 10, remember that. Nice little step through, up and under, and the ability to finish with the offhands. Kids at home, work on your offhand. Doug McDermott, again, look at this. Good feet, shot clock at 5, doesn't panic. Nice little step through.
Zach Hansen at the free throw line. Makes the first. Ed now played the last two games. Hansen in the box score.
Greg McDermott really likes this kid. Thinks he's going to be really, really good. Nice piece to start to build around after all your seniors are out of here next year.
19-point lead, largest lead of the game. Who steps up for Villanova? Pinkston gets fouled again. He'll go back to the free throw line, and he has certainly been more aggressive in the second half, especially the last couple of minutes.
Yeah, they're looking for him too, and now instead of going east to west or sideline to sideline, Villanova's coming down and throwing that ball, going to the rim, north to south. That's how you have to keep the pressure on Creighton, keep them on their heels going towards the basket.
Kingston coming off a double-double. Makes the free throw. And 14 points, 11 rebounds against DePaul. Dylan Ennis checks back in. Makes them both. And again, off the made free throw, set up a little bit of pressure. Gibbs against Hilliard. Hilliard's got 3 fouls. Brooks, the hesitation with the left hand.
Creighton is really exposed. The weak side of the defense for Villanova. It's one-on-one in the corner. They're not coming in to help. Opens up the lane.
Hilliard gets cut off baseline. Kingston, a reach-in foul. This will be against Gibbs. And we're going to have free throws here for Kingston as Villanova's already in the bonus.
It's the best thing that can happen. Down 19, Villanova has to be able to score while the shot clock and the game clock is stopped, and this is how you do it.
Kingston makes the front end. And Hans Manigot comes back in, replacing Grant Gibbs for Creighton. 8 points for Kingston. Now has 9. He had 0 in the first half. Brooks, the jumper. That's in and out, and the rebound pulled down by Bill. Kingston against Hansen. Too strong, and a rebound for McDermott.
And a great move, too. Got Hansen on his heels. Nice little step through, just too strong, but got what he wanted.
Foul away from the ball. This will go against Ryan Archidiakono as he pulled down Zach Hansen.
Now, here's where the problem lies for Villanova. They switch everything, and Creighton recognizes that. If there's a big downstairs on a little, what do you do from there?
McDermott against Bell. The Dirk got it again.
Thought he got away with a high elbow there. That right elbow was pretty high. Bell didn't sell it, though, and another nice little soft fadeaway.
31 for McDermott. His 9th 30-point game of the year. 23rd of his career. 10 minutes to play here in the second half. Hilliard, good take, got bumped by Maniga. And Hilliard will go back to the free throw line.
Check out the McDermott footwork again, but watch that right arm.
Thought that was kind of high into the chin. But still stays with the play. Take another look. Shoulder square. You know, so many coaches at times say, don't fade away. You know, I was always taught you can lean in or you can fade away as long as those shoulders are square. Doug McDermott's showing you that can be done.
Manigault will go to the bench, as will Hansen. Roggi checks back in, and Austin Chapman comes back in. Josh Hart comes back for Villanova. Archie Diacono goes to the bench. McDermott said, obviously, he watched Dirk Nowitzki and wanted to perfect that move, and that move has helped him so much this year. But it was Larry Bird, Paul Pierce, Wally Szczerbiak, three guys that he's watched a lot of video of.
All pretty good feet, yeah. Huh? Offensively as well.
And if you think about it, all players who are similar to him, not uber athletes, but they know how to get open, they know how to maximize their skill.
Interesting that none of those players will be in the all-defensive team.
McDermott, step back, that's short, but he got hit on the arm by James Bell, and he'll go to the free throw line.
Just step the guard, you try to get up there and contest a little bit. You know, you almost have to get him while he's putting the ball on the floor. Pick, nice little pop. Nice efficient spin move, meaning he doesn't waste time halfway through the spin and trying to force his shoulders to get square because he's not all the way around. He spins like a top, gets himself square to shoot that ball.
McDermott had that decision to make last year, do you stay for your senior year or do you go pro? His dad said, do me a favor, wake up one morning as if you made the decision to go pro. Enact that entire day as if you've gone pro. Now wake up another morning as if you made the decision to come back to school. Enact that entire day and see which one you like.
So the first day you wake up as a pro, is there 10 million sitting at the foot of your bed?
No, because you haven't signed it yet.
Well,
Ennis has it blocked by McDermott. And now a foul will be called here against Javon Pinkston.
It worked for Greg McDermott. I got to ask him about that theory, though. Tell your son, which he says at home, he's just my son. We don't really talk basketball. Which is, it's a great relationship. It's a healthy relationship, too, because all of those out there who have either played for your parent or are coaches for your kids, there has to be a separation to keep the game healthy and to keep your player slash son or daughter loving the game. You know, if you're 100% of the time talking about basketball, it's tough. There's a lot of pressure for kids, even at the college level. So really a good job by Greg McDermott, you know, with that healthy basketball relationship with his son.
A 21-point lead for Creighton. Pinkston kicks it out. Chenault doesn't want the shot. Poked away by Roggi. Here come the Blue Jays. Zeared into the hoop. Got it in the foul.
Kid's tough, isn't he? Come on, you tell me this kid, Zeared, is not learning from playing with guys like Roggi. McDermott gives the toughness. Great shot fake. No help in the paint anywhere. Puts it on the floor, doesn't mess around with it, gets it up to the rim. Great benches, loving it.
Zeerden had 12 points against Long Beach State back on December 3rd. He's got 9 tonight, and that's the most since December 3rd. Ochefu gets fouled hard by Chapman going up. Ochefu, playing with those four fouls, will hit the free throw line.
Now, Villanova has not stopped looking towards the paint, looking towards the basket when the double team comes. It's just the struggle has been down the other end. Creighton, 64% from the field. And not that Villanova's lights out, but with 39, but they haven't abandoned. And a lot of times you get down and teams think, oh, let's just shoot threes, especially a team that shoots as many as Villanova does. They haven't done that, but the problem has been at the defensive end.
1 of 2 at the line for Ochefu. I don't know about you, but I'm just sitting here looking at the score saying, really, it's happening again? They're doing it again to Villanova? McDermott wants it against Pinkston. Brooks, nice crossover, takes the bump, can't finish. Pinkston with a rebound. Hilliard, good jab step. Underneath to Ochefu.
Got a good play going towards the basket. Hardest thing for teams to do when they're down this big is to play one possession at a time and not look ahead. Great set there for Villanova.
Searden in trouble. We've got a break in the action here. Creighton leads Villanova by 20 with 7:53 to go.
It is time for the Midtown Crossing Shootout. During today's shootout, Creighton is giving a gift card to Creighton for making the big shots. $25 for a big layup, $50 for a free throw, $75 for a three-pointer. Creighton, the vibrant restaurant with a cuisine atmosphere and kitchen, second none. Since they set you 221 Road D, and today's shooter, Joey, is sick to have a more shot. Each one of you will win a $50 Creighton gift card, and Joey will also receive a $500 Midtown Crossing shopping spree. Joey Crane wishes you good luck in today's shootout and good living. With an exciting menu of fresh sushi options, be sure to stop by Crane for a happy hour and a half-size sushi menu. All right, Joey, 30 seconds on the big board. On your mark, get set, go! Joey, no problem winning $25. 50 for a free throw. Can he knock it down? Getting the range right. Let's hear it for Joey. Come on, Joey.
Got you. We got you.
Got it. On to the three-pointer. Finds a spot. Ten seconds, Joey. Come on, Joey. 5 seconds. 2, 1. Get it one more. So close. Joey's gone to Creighton with a $50 gift card. Congratulations, Joey. Don't forget to use the 3-point shuttle on Midtown Crossing. 2 cents or less for each home game. It's courtesy of the Chicago Golf House and Saints Public Bank.
We're back here in Omaha, 20-point lead for Creighton over Villanova with 7:53 to go. And the game coming up after us, looking towards the tournament, which teams get in, how many from the Big East will get in. All of a sudden, as this season has been moving on, this conference seems to be getting stronger and stronger, and more teams could potentially get into the NCAA tournament.
Well, you have teams that have some depth, you know, Creighton, Xavier, obviously Villanova has a style that they play. You can't forget about Georgetown and Providence. Georgetown has a tough game coming up later, but you know, those teams grind it out. They're pretty. They have some special players at the guard spot.
The lob into McDermott. Kick out. Robbie for three. Finally got one. And a foul is going to go against Villanova as well.
This is when you have to keep your emotions in check if you're Villanova. Now play the right way. The game looks out of hand on the scoreboard, but you can't let your emotions get the best of you. We're watching the ball, but take a look right here.
Count the basket.
Just don't need it.
Ethan Robbie.
Now you've done your job. You boxed out. The ball's through the basket. This is just insult to injury here.
The foul is against Tony Chenault. They're going to the monitor. My guess is, well, they've already said the basket's good. A three for Rogge. And going to get two free throws. Excuse me, one and one here. For McDermott.
Taking a look, just a simple shove. I don't think it was. No punches thrown.
It was acting there as well.
McDermott sold it pretty well. Jimmy Burr still falls for that stuff. I used to get over on him a lot when I played, but not now. He's been around. He's a seasoned vet.
I was going to ask if you ever, you know, acted with Jim Burr as the referee when your games.
Absolutely. It's just not fun if you don't.
Who was the best actor that you played with?
That I played with?
With.
Oh, gosh.
Or against.
I don't think there was anyone better. You know who the best was and one of the best all-time players in the Big East? Lawrence Mope. Had to be one of the best actors on the court, just knew how to sell it. Listen, he was a tremendous player,
right.
A great player, but Lawrence Mope really knew how to get the most out of every single game.
That will be the 10th team foul against Villanova, so it will be 2 points here for Doug McDermott. And you see McDermott with 33 points here today. Now his last five games, including this, 39, 32, 25, 26, and 33 here tonight. That's not bad.
That's some shabby.
Oh, and a couple of game winners in there as well.
And he'd be the first one to tell you it's great to score, but winning is so much more important. And how far his team goes has to be at the top of the list above scoring.
Let me throw this at you as we're talking about the tournament teams and whatnot. How far can a team like Creighton, which has a McDermott, a dynamic player, surrounded by a bunch of guys who can shoot the ball and be good role players, how far can they go? What kind of run can they make?
They can go as far as those jumpers from deep will take them.
Oh, how about that roll for James Bell? And now he has a chance for a four-point play.
That's what you call a shooter's bounce. That thing bounced up as high as the shot clock bounced again. I mean, take a look. That's how high this ball bounces. Over the backboard. Two bounces and in.
And he gets the four-point play. Avery Dingman will check in, replacing Grant Gibbs. 83-62. Creighton in the two games against Villanova is shooting a combined 60% from the floor. Dangerous pass here and a nice handle. And that pass is deflected by Bell. Out of bounds stays Creighton basketball. By the way, this game sold out in 15 minutes. The announced attendance, 18,797, second largest in school history. Chapman pulls up. Short, Rogge trying to keep it alive. And it's out of bounds off of Rogge.
We talk about Creighton and one of their deficiencies is not having size inside. I mean, they really know how to hide it. They tack you down inside defensively. Do a pretty good job of bringing a lot of guys to the board.
Jenkins' difficult shot over here. Gets it to go. Jenkins in some trouble. He's going to call time. With 27 seconds on a shot clock, was in danger of a 10-second violation. Saturday, the UFC returns to Fox Sports 1 with UFC 170 prelims as Alexa Davis takes on Jessica Eye plus other epic bouts. It all begins with a pre-fight show at 7 Eastern right here, and it's all part of Speed Weeks on Fox Sports 1. If you're Jay Wright and you're Villanova, what are you thinking right now?
I'm thinking this last 6:43, I have to teach my team. We've been through this already once. This is a feeling, especially with only a couple losses on the season, that I think you have to hammer home to your team and say, you see how this feels?
You look up at that scoreboard, this is a feeling you never want to feel again. I'm sure he was telling them that as we spoke to him before the game, saying, you know, and I've watched that game two, three times back, and it really looked like they were a boxer that came out with their hands down and got hit. This game, you know, this was kind of the same type. Doug McDermott gets it going early. The crowd is into it. Villanova just couldn't get them out of, get the crowd out of the game.
England lost it. Here comes Pinkston. Pinkston will throw it down.
Again, all about playing the right way this last 6.5 minutes or so.
They break the press. Sheridan thought about the three. Sheridan all the way to the hoop. He gets fouled hard by Bell as he goes down. And I think it's a good foul by Bell.
Yeah, and so much is put into how the player hits the deck. But again, look at no help. What happens is when you have great three-point shooters, you have to stay home. I mean, you have to stay hugged up on a guy, and that leaves the wide open lane for guys.
They're going to the monitor. They're going to say it's a flagrant one against Bell, and I know the elbow got the face, but I'm going to be honest with you right now. He was going for the ball.
You take another look. It's just the angle. He's swiping across. I totally disagree, and I don't.
He's going for the ball.
It's just, it really, and it reminds me, you know, a lot of players around the league, in the Big East, the NBA, the game is really, and Kobe Bryant made this point a few weeks back, it's softened up. I mean, you can't foul a guy. It's just too much. And I understand you want to protect the players, but it's an overreaction. It's just like you don't want players to overreact, you can't have the officials overreacting to a play. These guys are veteran officials. They've been around. That is not a flagrant foul.
And not just is that a flagrant one, it's also the fifth foul against James Bell, so he's gone with 6:11 to go. But again, everyone says, did he make a play on the ball? Yeah, he was going for the ball.
Again, a lot of it comes down to how players hit the deck. Zierden lands on his feet. I think it's just a two-shot foul or a personal foul.
Good backdoor cut by Chapman with the left hand, puts it in.
Villanova overextending, trying to get pressure up on the ball. Leaves those lanes to be able to cut back door for a wide open layup.
In and out, and a rebound for McDermott. McDermott's got 35 points and 6 rebounds on the night. Brooks against Hart, and a rebound for Hilliard, up ahead for Pinkston. And Pinkston will get fouled by Chapman. Crowd doesn't like it. Neither does Chapman.
Here's a great angle right here. Wow.
Oh, that was a lot of ball.
You know, the game has been cleanly officiated, and obviously we can't nitpick. It's not the officials' fault, and I know exactly. When you get to this point in the game, the officials want to keep it clean. But some of those plays... That play right there was clean. Maybe the ref didn't have the right angle, but it's a tough game to officiate. These kids are strong, they're fast, they're big. You know what I'd like? I'd like some of the officials to go through the same workouts that the players do in the offseason. You know what I mean? You're playing the same game, at least maybe, or you could do 50% of it to kind of get the feel of what the players are going through, running up and down the floor. Staying with the play, I think, is most important for officials.
Under 5 to play. Chapman. Oh, what a move!
kid special. He really gets forgotten about because you have guys like Rogge and McDermott who can shoot the lights out and are such special players.
7 points, 8 assists, and now he draws the charge against Tony Chenault.
Offensive foul on Villanova's number 5, Tony Chenault. That's his third personal.
Just take a look at the pity pat. Brings it back, crosses it back over. Again, no help on that backside. And then look at this, the defense. Lower that shoulder, Chapman takes the contact and draws the offensive.
Timeout taken here by Villanova, and next Big East basketball presented by New York Life Insurance Company continues as Georgetown takes on St. John's with coverage beginning right after our game. It's all part of Speed Weeks here on Fox Sports 1. St. John's able to squeak out a victory at Seton Hall on Thursday night. Literally squeaked out the victory by 1 point. They're playing good basketball. I would say coming into this game that it was Villanova and St. John's as the two hottest teams in the conference.
Jay Wright said they were playing well the first time they met Creighton. At least he thought they were playing very well at the time.
And just to let you know, that St. John's game after us is actually going to start on Fox Sports 2. We'll get you to that game as soon as this one is over. Out of bounds. Chapman thought he was fouled.
To Villanova.
Villanova basketball with 4:27 to go in a 21-point game. That's 89 points here for Creighton.
It's a good trap, though. I wish more teams would do that. It's more old-school basketball. You pick up full court to try to get a steal, not just to slow the pace down.
Yeah, it seemed like, I'm going to say, back when you were playing and even after, a full-court press was used to force turnovers.
Well, these kids are more talented nowadays.
A three by Jenkins.
And they're just offensively more gifted. Back then, you had to press because most teams, that's all the offense they had was coming up with steals.
Gibbs gets fouled by Josh Hart. Justin Kutcher alongside Johnny Marshall here at CenturyLink Center in Omaha. 18,797 fans here. They have been loud for much of this game. Now it's just a matter of the game's turned into a blowout. Grant Gibbs, the free throw line, a sixth year senior. Great story about Gibbs. You mentioned it before. McDermott gave up his scholarship so that Gibbs could play this year on scholarship. That means that Greg McDermott has to foot the bill for the season this year. But, you know, if Doug gets drafted and makes some money, maybe he sends him a bill for that. But earlier this year, Bill Raftery was here for a game and had a practice. There's Gibbs and Raft talking. McDermott walks by and goes, oh, look, the two old guys. The sixth-year senior, they like to have fun.
It's a great relationship. Gibbs tells him, listen, the walk-ons have to grab all the bags. They got to get the balls in after practice, all the walk-ons.
Chapman gets it over. Coming up on 3.5 to go. McDermott against Jenkins. Fade away again, 37 for McDermott.
Just, it comes out of his hand, great rotation. The release point is perfect. No one can get to it, especially when he creates more space leaning away.
Pinkston against Rogge, spins right into him, able to put it in. Javon Pinkston, now with 15 points all coming in this half.
The other game's loosened up for him a little bit. No double teams coming. He's going to work one-on-one on that block.
At this point, the Blue Jays not looking to shoot too early in the shot clock. And Zierden gets fouled by Josh Hart. 2:42 to go. Doug McDermott's got 37 points. The folks at the Crescent Mool Ale House, they're loving it, as are the fans here. 92-75, Creighton on top. Thanks, Greg. It is all Creighton here in Omaha playing at home, looking for their first home win over a top six ranked team since January 29th of 1970 when they beat number five, New Mexico State. And this is what they have done against Villanova this year. 96 in the first game, 92 points in this one. Villanova only allows under 67 points per game. Now imagine if you took out the two games against Creighton, how great those numbers would look.
They're the only team to score 90 points on them all season long. I mean, if you have, if you're Villanova, you have an Achilles heel, it's this team in gray. I mean, it's obviously not just because of the losses, but how you've lost to them.
What does this do for the psyche of Villanova?
Well, I guarantee you, Jay Wright will tell his team, we have to learn from our defeats and get better. They learned a lot about themselves today and the things they have to get better at. And I'm sure Jay Wright will be the first one to say that to the media and to his team. We can get better, and we will show them that today.
Kingston against Loggy. Hart steps back for three. Long. And a rebound for McDermott.
Just have to shoot the ball. Catch it. Whoever catches it looking down to see where his feet are. Just can't do it.
Coming up next, we've got Georgetown and St. John's. 2 minutes to play. Chapman kicks it out. McDermott with three on the shot clock. And he gets fouled by Kingston. And if you're Kingston, I understand it's 94-75. That shot clock's at three. McDermott's going backwards. Can't foul.
No, you just have to move your feet and, you know, understand that he's going to have to throw up a Hail Mary. And I don't think he thinks that he fouled. I think he just thinks there was some incidental contact there, but you're right. You just got to kind of back up, contest that.
38, a chance for McDermott to tie his season-high 39, which he set against St. John's back on January 28th. That's also when he hit one of his three game winners of the season. He's got 39, and he will go out to a standing ovation.
And if you are Creighton fans, great to see right there, father and son, coach and player. The fans, enjoy this while you can. Tell you what, it'll be a long time before you see a player anywhere in the country like Doug McDermott after this season.
Josh Hart draws the foul, but you watch McDermott interact with his teammates. His teammates all love him. You watch him interact with the fans. And before the game, or during shoot around, they've got high school kids coming. He takes group pictures, right? Well, he says he comes over. He actually comes over and talks to us, and that's that. And then he goes back, and it was supposed to be pictures done. But each kid won an individual picture. And he took an individual picture with each kid. And I thought to myself, he is a star, a legitimate star. Again, they've got a bobblehead giveaway for a college senior next week for Doug McDermott. But he, playing here, it's like he's an NBA player already. He has that star treatment, and he handles it with such class and dignity. It is awesome. And people have said he's just like his dad. He cannot say no.
And he handles it the right way. We talk about him watching great players on the floor. But he must, whoever he watches, whoever he's around, his mom and dad, I mean, they've done a terrific job because he handles himself like, let's face it, a lot of professional athletes don't.
Yeah.
I mean, he is very humble, one of the most humble people, not just players who will ever be. And it's a special thing, and it's nice for him to spread that amongst his teammates. I mean, he is Larry Bird to the kids around here. The guy who he idolized growing up, that's who he basically has become to these folks here.
The real flaw in his game is the facial hair. Just cannot grow the good mustache. Yeah.
Yeah. You just shave it, and it will come.
99-77. 1 minute left to play. I don't think anybody anticipated this. This team is so good here at home. Ennis, the deep three, no good. The rebound for Brooks. And let's see if they get a timeout just to get the subs in. They will do just that. Time now for our Land Rover player of the game, and I'm going to give you one guess. Yep, Doug McDermott. 39 points, ties a season high. So efficient from the floor. 13 of 17 from the field. 4-6 from the three-point line. 9 of 9 at the free throw line. He got this team started, and they just took off from there. Got this crowd into it. The overrated chants begin, and Greg McDermott quickly looks towards the student body and says, cut it out. Stephen Farini doesn't get much time. He gets 2 points. And they're over 100 here in Omaha. How about that, though? Greg McDermott tells the student section, hey, cut it out. One of the overrated chants. That's what other coaches in this conference respect so much about Greg McDermott. Classy guy, the handshakes with Jay Wright, 101-80. A 21-point lead, a 21-point win for the Creighton Blue Jays, their first home win over a top 10 team since 1973, and the first time they've ever beat two top 10 teams in one season. Doug McDermott put on a show here today, 39 points. His father, Greg McDermott, got a nice hug afterwards. And Villanova is handed their second loss of the season in conference play. Both of them coming at the hands of these Creighton Blue Jays. And if you're Jay Wright and you're Villanova, you gotta be thinking, what do we have to do against these guys? Because obviously, they play us very, very well. 101-80. Number 18, Creighton defeats Villanova. And Donnie Marshall is standing by right now with the player of the game, Doug McDermott.
Thanks, Justin. It's interesting because as we sit here and talk about how humble Doug McDermott is, the first thing he says to me is, he needs me to do every game. He has some big games. I wish I could take credit for that. But this game today really was, and we've talked about how special you are as a scorer and a teammate, not just your ability to play basketball, but today you passed Larry Bird on the all-time collegiate scoring list. What does that mean to you?
You know, it means a lot. You know, that's a guy I looked up to. I watch a lot of film on him, but imagine if he had a three-point line and he stayed 4 years. He'd be way ahead of me. So, you know, it's really cool. I'm going to embrace it, but there's a lot of season left.
Listen, you guys played Villanova earlier this season. You blew them out of the water. You come back today. What were your expectations with them in preparing for this game?
You know, we thought they'd take away Ethan better, and that's what they did. And it opened up a lot for our other guys. So we had to take advantage of that. You know, they're a great team. They're going to make a great run. And, you know, they're one of the best teams in the country. So we're fortunate to walk away with them.
The biggest game probably this school and these fans have seen really in the history of the program today. Now moving forward, you guys aren't under the radar anymore. How will you approach with your teammates and obviously your coach? I don't want to say dad. I know it's a coach when you're in the uniform. Moving forward the rest of this Big East season.
You know, we got to continue to have that chip on our shoulder. You know, everyone's going to want to come after us because we're playing great ball. You know, there's still a lot of great teams in the Big East that we have to face. So we got to stay humble. We got to go get ready for Marquette now.
Great win. Congratulations. Good luck the rest of the way. All right, Justin.
It was indeed a great win for the Creighton Blue Jays and Doug McDermott. Creighton 101, Villanova 80. Let's go back to Greg Wolf and Austin Crozier in our Fox College Hoop Studios.